hold the colors. Welcome to the graduation of the class of 2022. At this time, it is my honor and privilege to introduce the class president, Ms. Olivia Freiberg.
Good afternoon. I'm the president of the class of 2022, and it is an honor to welcome you all here today on behalf of my class. I'm very happy to have the privilege of speaking in front of all of you. We are gathered here to celebrate the graduation of the class of 2022, along with all of our amazing accomplishments. First and foremost, I would like to thank the staff here at North Fond du Lac for helping our class make it into this gym today. I think we all know that this class has a lot of character and can be a lot to handle at times, especially during basketball season, whether it's rushing onto the court after a big win or never staying behind the line. Without our staff, we wouldn't be receiving our diploma today. They continued to push us even when we weren't the slightest bit motivated. Our 4 years of high school were like no other due to the pandemic, but our staff continued to help us grow and learn. I would like to give a special thank you to our advisors, Ms. Fox, Ms. Sabo, and Mr. Keel. These three amazing people helped make the past 4 years better than we ever could have imagined. And for that, I say thank you. Next, I would like to thank the wonderful parents and family members in this gym today. Our parents have helped us through the good and bad. It was our parents who chose to put us through education, and for that we should be forever grateful. Our parents have raised us into the amazing people that we are today, and even though they weren't the ones writing the papers or taking the tests, they helped us get us where we are. They pushed us every step of the way, even when they had you crying over your math homework on the kitchen table. The staff and our parents are amazing people, and I know that they could not be more proud of our class and the people that we will become. Thank you.
Thank you, Olivia. Please give a warm welcome to the class salutatorian, Autumn Belangi.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Autumn Belangi, and as the salutatorian of the 2022 Orange Sand High School Senior Class, I would like to take this time to thank each and every one of you for attending this ceremony. Well, I know you all have had several more speeches to sit through today. I'd like to acknowledge the hard work that all of my classmates have put into this accomplishment and many others. As freshmen, our class definitely had our troubles. Thankfully, we went from being in jeopardy of not having a senior trip to being the young adults sitting here today. We have grown tremendously from our 14-year-old selves. In just 4 years, we've made new friends, we've lost some other friends, and regained friendships with former friends. And where we all have our differences, our class finds ways to embrace them and come together. As an example of this, we are senior prank. It wasn't just one friend group that put together the entire thing. We had different cliques that had spread out our class diversity. Like the growth we have endured, we are in varying stages. Some of our classmates can't wait to get out of here and start their lives and turn a new friend, whereas others can't quite let it go. Graduation is a major milestone in anyone's life, and I'm ecstatic to say that we have achieved it. While all of our successes look different, we have all conquered a great task. Some of our students have accomplished this while working a full-time job, some while participating in not one, but maybe the two or more sports simultaneously, and some through other extracurriculars. While our success varies in difference of experiences and grade point averages, without looking between the lines, we have all entered this battle, and we have all come out triumphant. With our success, we have all had different paths to pursue. And even though our proceedings are exciting, it is still matter how many stories are told to us and all the lists of what to expect and here's how it'll go, it is truly an oblivion, and not one person knows how to actually turn out. And the unknown is terrifying. But even with the unknown future, we can all say we survived high school. Through the multitude of sweat and abundance of tears, and occasionally the drop of blood, we've endured freshman year, COVID quarantine, a worldwide pandemic, online classes, hybrid learning, and many other challenges. The majority of our high school experience is rare and unusual, but we have ourselves, our family, and our district to thank for being here today. Thank you.
Thank you, Autumn. At this time, our concert will be presenting John Williams in Concert, arranged by Paul Lavender, directed by Miss Julia Leggery. Band members, would you please come back?
sit up here and stare at my note card, so I'm going to stare at my phone instead. But the main reason I changed my speech is an experience that I've had over the past week. I started a full-time job this week at Grande Cheese. It's an alright job, it pays pretty well, it's simple, and the people are really nice. I even enjoy it a little bit. I spend about 8.5 hours every day peeling Parmesan cheese. Sometimes I get to peel Asiago cheese, but let me tell you that that's a real thrill. In short, my heart is not in the job, clearly. It's peeling cheese, you can't really get too intertwined in that. But this made me think a little. I have a lot of time to think when all I do is peel cheese. I wake up every morning at 3:30 a.m. so I can be to work by 5. I then go home at 1:30, eat lunch, and then I sit till 5 in the afternoon so I can go to the gym at 6. I get home at 8:30 from there so I can be to bed by 10 and repeat this cycle every single weekday and even on some weekends. I reflected on my schedule this past Friday and I realized something. I wrote this speech in the break room. Currently, I am living to work. I wake up to work, I center my sleep schedule around my work. This is where my point comes. That's no way to live. So I wrote this speech during that time. Everyone here should have the goal to work to live rather than live to work. I encourage all of you to find something you're truly passionate about. Don't sell yourself short. Do a job that you enjoy. And if you don't enjoy it, then leave. Life is much too short to spend that way. More importantly, don't work yourself to death. Enjoy your weekends, your vacations, your time off. We've realized, especially with the events of the past 2 weeks, that life is extremely short. Spend time with your family and friends. Live life to the fullest. Don't let your work dominate your life. And let your work be enjoyable. This is my goal, and I think it should be everyone's goal too. So, congratulations to you all, and good luck.
Thank you, Ivy. Heavy nervous for a minute there, but great job. Classmates wanted you to bring some cheese, too. Please welcome our third valedictorian, McKenna Lee Gash. Thank you. valedictorians. At this time, the choir will be singing Gone, Gone, Gone by Clark Furman and Wanberg, directed by Mr. Anthony Rasmussen. Choir members, please come on. again, great job to our choir. Mr. Matheson, let's give him another round of applause. At this time, it's my pleasure, we were just talking about how many years this has been. 13 together? 13 years together doing this. So please welcome our superintendent, Mr. Aaron Seda.
Welcome everybody to Oriole Nation. My name is Aaron Sadoff, aka Mr. Sadoff, to some Mr. Connie. I'm very happy to be here today, celebrating a great day. First off, I want to thank Nick, getting involved. Nice message. Also Wyatt, when we have a choice, the peel cheese, that's Scott with a choice. You know, but we want to work to live. We want our life to be full as we go. Wonderful. Then McKenna, embrace your heart, be uncomfortable, change. Wonderful stuff. Today, we celebrate the class of 2022. And I am proud to be the superintendent of the school district and to be here on my favorite day of the year, June 5th. Today is the beginning of a new journey, and what a great, exciting journey will be for all. But before we do that, I first want to give some big thanks to so many people that helped make this happen. So if you would please, first thanks, Ms. McGill, Freeman, give her a big round of applause. As I read your name, if you're not standing, stand up. If you're standing, wave. If you want to look on top by the rainbow over there. So I want to thank, special thank yous to Ms. Levitt, Ms. Marquardt, Ms. Gable, Ms. Nitz, Ms. Stahl, Mr. Anderson. Let's also keep it going for Dave, Ken, Pete, Jenny, Ron, Josh, Mike, Anita, and Chris. Because of them, we have this all set up here. We have all these beautiful flowers, and we have that great program. Mrs. McGill, Freeman, we have some more things to give.
Could I have all teachers or all employees who work in our district please stand at this time? Thank you for supporting our school.
Brothers, sisters, This great group of people would not be here. At this time, all high school seniors in the class of 2022 would take your hands, put them above your head like this, and start to say, oh. One more time, oh. You now, family, friends, have just gotten a standing ovation from the class of 2022. Well done.
Treat
that even if I don't like you, even if you've wronged me, even if I'm not of the same political persuasion, or if I look different or sound different, I will find value in you and I will treat you with dignity. And at the bare minimum, I won't be mean to you. My challenge to you is get away from that old thing where you gotta earn my respect. You gotta earn my respect. Forget that. Because if you're gonna make people earn your respect, you're gonna be a lonely human being. I guarantee that if you give respect to everybody and you treat them with dignity and kindness, you will get it back tenfold. Well, guys, that's it. Remember, we get to give reasons why things happen. Make them good. Give away respect like candy at a parade. Expect nothing back from others, but give it away. You will have love, you will have friendship, until that end of the degree, you won't know what to do with it. I'm very, very proud of all of you. 13 years have flown by, haven't they? Once an Oriole, always an Oriole, class of 2022. You've earned a day. I am really glad that I've been part of your education, and thank you for making the world better. It's better because of all of you. Woo!
Thank you, Mr. Seda. Next year, when hopefully you can graduate.
We're hoping.
All right, we're hoping. You can come back and give that standing ovation. Today is one of those great occasions when we get to celebrate these great students, their achievements, their perseverances, and their successes. It's one of the times you can take a break and reflect, feeling good as a parent, grandparent, or a mentor, knowing that the kids you care about are doing fine and they're on the right path. We've heard a lot of stories today about your life as a high school student. You've survived Google Meets, Zoom Meets. I'm hearing now that many of you were fishing, maybe laying in bed while these were happening, but hey, you made it happen. Took place in hybrid learning. Some of you took your exams in kitchens or again on a boat. But we're back to everything normal this year. We had a great homecoming, we had a great prom, and we're having a great graduation. Students, please also don't forget all that you accomplished while in high school. All the friendships you've created, the memories, our musicals, sporting events, track team, fishing team, archery team, field trips, dances, and so many activities. Your class was able to have time off during study halls and oral time. You definitely use the village bulky pickup to your advantage. Thank you everyone for your help with that. If you didn't know, it was a great senior brain. And take a look today, we've got some awesome caps decorated. Hopefully you're going to miss your lunch crew. There's a few tables, I don't know guys. Sorry, yeah. Lunch table, move on. Moms and dads and parents are there. We worked really hard to make sure our table was clean. Grapes are not good at lunch. Blueberries are not good at lunch. They fly a lot. So we're working on that. Your class motto is, the best feeling in the whole world is watching things finally fall into place after watching them fall apart so long. Today, things fell into place. More ways than one. The celebration today reinforces the idea that if graduates steer themselves in the right direction, they will be rewarded for their efforts. Nora Ephron stated, your education is a dress rehearsal for a life that is yours to lead. We've heard a lot about that today, all the choices you will make. Graduates, I always like to share this part. Mr. Rasmussen reminded me to make sure I include this. You should know that today is the day that moms and dads and guardians are very proud of you. They have high hopes for you. They believe in you, and you're making them proud by showing what you can do. Take a look at them now. Find them in the stands. You can see them smiling or snapping photos so they can record this moment forever. Today is an important day for you and for them. They are very proud of you. Today is a great day to ask them for money. Today is also a day that we've heard in our reflections to hug them, to be in the moment, to thank them for supporting you. Because as much as this is your achievement, This is also the achievement of all the people who care about you. That means your mom, your dad, your stepmom, your stepdad, your grandparents, your aunts and uncles, your sisters and brothers, everyone in your life that cares about you. They want you to be your best and to live a happy life. So just again, a few reminders for you as you graduate. I encourage each one of you to not always text one another, to really talk to each other, whether it be a phone call or a lunch date or just a quick coffee together. Listen to one another and appreciate one another. I ask you to take this chance to dedicate yourself to making the next year even better. You don't have to follow the crowd. Be yourself. Be an upstander. Do the right thing, even if no one is watching. Most of all, be kind. Princess Diana shared, "Carry out a random act of kindness with no exception or reward, save the knowledge that someday someone might do the same for you." And finally, don't be in too big of a hurry to grow up. There are some great times ahead in your life. Many of you shared this week, where did the year go? It flew by. We have the chance to walk through the halls of friendship for the class of 2034. All of you were like, gosh, you're so little. And they were so excited to see you. Remember, be in that moment. The years are going to fly by. Don't rush past them. Enjoy your moments, big or small. No matter how your year went, no matter how many ups and downs, you did it and you succeeded. You're ready for the next step. Continue to be resilient. Never before, since the beginning of time, has there ever been anybody exactly like you, and never again, throughout all the ages to come, will there be anybody exactly like you again, shared Dale Carnegie. Class of 22, go out there and be the best that you can. Nora Flanelak, School Board, and Mr. Aaron Seda, members of the class of 2022 have met the requirements established by the state of Wisconsin and the North Flanelak School District. At this time, it is my honor and privilege to present the class of 2022 for the awarding of their diplomas. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mrs. Jill Gable and Mrs. Jenny Stahl, who will be reading the names of the graduates and announce their postgraduate plans. Congratulations, graduates.
appointment at Able Farms while attending Fox Valley Technical College to be an agribusiness agronomy technician. Mackenzie K. Finn Mathers. Mackenzie plans to attend Marine Park Technical College for EMT paramedic program. Natalie Rose Miller. Natalie plans to attend Lakeland University pursuing a degree in psychology while playing softball. She later will pursue her master's in school counseling. Leah Alana Orlando. Leah plans to attend Beachy Beauty School for her beautician cosmetic certification while also joining the Navy Reserve in July. Madison Marie Mount. Madison plans to attend Milwaukee Institute of Art and Design pursuing a degree in fine arts. Elizabeth Rock. Bree plans to attend UW Oshkosh pursuing a degree in elementary education. Easton Marcus Rail. Easton plans to attend UW Oshkosh pursuing a degree in business marketing. Lure Joanne Elise Rolden. Laura plans to pursue art and economics in the Netherlands, Utrecht. Joseph Michael Schmidt. Joy plans to directly enter the workforce. Casey Marie Skelton. W. Stevens Point pursuing a degree in psychology. Nolan Hunter Stark. Nolan plans to attend Fox Valley Technical College pursuing a degree in natural resources. Taylor James Schumacher. Taylor plans to attend UW South pursuing a degree in game design. Carson Dale Giddens. Carson wants to attend UW Platteville pursuing a degree in mechanical engineering. Alyssa Marie Peterson. Pursuing a degree in forensics investigation. Douglas James Martin. Douglas plans to attend UW Oshkosh Fogelag campus, pursuing a degree in music education. Evelyn Marie Neary. Josie Lynn Wallander. Josie plans to attend UW Oshkosh, pursuing a degree in accounting. Malachi William Metzel. Malachi plans to attend UW Platteville, pursuing a degree in mechanical engineering. Ian Alan Orson. Ian enlisted in the United States Marines on June 22nd, Hannah plans to directly enter the workforce.
Preston
B. Terry Prowse. Gabriella, Lillian Ojeda. Lillian plans to directly enter the workforce. Madison Rose Schrank. Madison plans to directly enter the workforce. Owen Michael Zimmer. Owen has secured employment at AirTech Heating and Cooling. Hannah Lillian Schaefer. Hannah plans to attend Green Park Technical College for cosmetology. Logan Paul Schneider. Logan plans to attend Northeast Wisconsin Technical College pursuing a degree in electrical power distribution. Janaya Tamia Starling.
Color guard, please retire the colors.